Dear students, let us discuss the biochemical basis of paracetamol toxicity. First, let's begin with the structure of paracetamol. Paracetamol is acetaminophen. So, you all know this structure. This is what? Benzene ring. Okay. If you put a OH group here, that will be your phenol. Okay. If you put a amino group here, that will be your ortho-amino-phenol. If you put a amino group in this position, it will be your meta-amino-phenol. Okay. If you put in the opposite side, that is the para position, that will be your para-amino-phenol. Okay. If you acetylate that amino group, add a CH3C double bond O group, that will become N-acetyl-p-benzoquinone. Clear? So, that is your paracetamol. Paracetamol is nothing but N-acetyl-p-benzoquinone. See this? This is para position. Okay? This is your acetyl group attached to the nitrogen. That is why it is N-acetyl-p-benzoquinone. So, if you take these words acid, amino, phen, the four letters of each word acid, amino, phen. So, you combine them to produce acetaminophen. Now, you are getting why paracetamol is known as acetaminophen. Okay, clear. So, with this, let us go to the paracetamol toxicity. Maximum recommended therapeutic dose of paracetamol is 4 gram per day in adults, 50 to 75 milligram per kilogram per day in children. The toxic symptoms develop when 8 gram per day is given over many days or a single dose of 10 to 15 gram is given. Okay. The toxicity features are nausea, vomiting, elevated transaminases. Okay. Here we will focus on the biochemical perspective. So, I want you to know what is the mechanism of this toxicity, what is the biochemical basis. For that, we should first understand how paracetamol is metabolized in the body. The major organ involved in the metabolism of drugs is your liver. Okay. We all know that biotransformation reaction, that is detoxification of xenobiotics, happen in liver. Intestine and kidney also plays a minor role. Okay, the major role is played by liver. In biotransformation reaction, we know that there are two phases, phase 1 and phase 2. Phase 1 is mediated by cytochrome P450 mixed function oxidases. Phase 2 is conjugation reaction. Okay. Those drugs which are already having polar residues can directly go to phase 2 conjugation reaction instead of going first to phase 1 then to phase 2. For example, isoniazid. Isoniazid is having a polar group. It can directly go to phase 2. Paracetamol, we already have seen that it is having a polar group. There is a OH group, right? There is a polar group. It can directly undergo phase 2 conjugation reaction. Okay. So, we are seeing the normal metabolism of paracetamol directly undergoes glucuronidation. What is glucuronidation? Addition of UDP glucuronic acid. What is glucuronic acid? It is a derivative of glucose. Okay. Glucuronic acid, that means the aldehyde group is free. The acid group is coming from oxidation of 6th OH. Okay. OH attached to the 6th carbon. Okay. Whenever we say uronic acid, that means the functional group, the aldehyde group is free. Okay. In UDP glucuronic acid, the aldehyde group is free. Remember that. So we add glucuronic acid, so it is a polar molecule. Paracetamol glucuronide can be easily excreted in the urine. Paracetamol also undergoes another conjugation reaction, which is sulfation. Okay, so here the donor is PAPS. We have studied this in xenobiotics class. Sulfation to produce paracetamol sulfate, and it is excreted in the urine. Okay, so the majority is conjugation reaction. 50 to 55% is your glucuronidation. 30 to 40% is your sulfation reaction. Clear? Very minor amount goes to cytochrome P450 mediated mixed function oxidase reaction. Okay, in this N-acetyl-p-benzoquinoneimine, your highly reactive molecule is produced. So this is reactive molecule. So this should be detoxified by another conjugation reaction. Here glutathione is so uric acids. Okay, paracetamol mercaptourate is produced, which is on gamma glutamyl cysteinyl glycine. SH group of glutathione is involved in this reaction to produce non-toxic, and it is excreted in the urine. Clear? When you give excess paracetamol, let's see what is going to happen. Okay, paracetamol overdose. So what will happen? There will be glucuronidation, sulfation, all these enzymes, they have a limit. Okay, after some point of time, these enzymes, they will be saturated. See, glucuronidation will be saturated, sulfation will be saturated. Okay, the only way is now cytochrome P450 mediated mixed function oxidase reaction. Okay, so what will happen? N-acetyl-p-benzoquinoneimine will be produced, and it will be produced in excess amount. Okay, this causes glutathione depletion. Okay, because N-acetyl-p-benzoquinoneimine is high, so all the glutathione will be used up in the conjugation reaction, and finally this molecule will accumulate. I told you this is a reactive molecule. So what exactly this reactive molecule is going to do? Let's see. This forms adducts with the proteins. Okay, so this adduct will interfere in the function of proteins, and it also produces new antigens. Okay, new antigen is produced. Okay, so these are the protein adducts by the molecule. That is why in paracetamol poisoning, this cysteinyl adduct is used as a marker to see the level of toxicity. Okay, this is very important. Now let us see how to treat this condition. We will see the biochemical basis. So we all know the problem is N-acetyl-p-benzoquinoneimine. Okay, and glutathione depletion. So these are the problem. Okay, so all we need is to reduce this molecule to increase the glutathione so that the conjugation can happen. Okay, so glutathione is gamma glutamyl cysteinyl glycine. The rate limiting step of glutathione synthesis is the availability of cysteine. So to maintain cysteine level in the blood, we are going to give N-acetyl-cysteine. Okay, N-acetyl-cysteine will be converted into glutathione. Okay, and this glutathione will react with N-acetyl-p-benzoquinoneimine both enzymatically and non-enzymatically. Enzyme is glutathione, yes, transferase. Okay, this enzyme will transfer glutathione, and non-enzymatically also it will react with this to excrete the molecule. Clear? IV route is preferred over oral route, and therapy should begin within 8 hours of ingestion. After 36 hours, the therapy is ineffective. Liver transplantation is the only way. Clear? Now, let us see. This is a question given by a student from Nigeria. Okay? So, let us discuss this question also. So this is actually wrong, the initial portion. It is Peter and Paul. Okay, Peter and Paul are biological brothers placed on therapeutic dose of N-acetyl-p-benzoquinone. What is this N-acetyl-p-benzoquinone? It is nothing but your paracetamol. Okay. So, this is the importance of knowing the chemical structure. See, the person who framed the question gave like this. So, they are placed on paracetamol for a feverish condition. Peter is a vegetarian. Okay. Paul is an alcoholic. Okay. Following days of consecutive treatment with the drug, discomforting signs were noticed in Paul that subsequently warranted urgent need for laboratory investigation. Paul is an alcoholic. Okay. One of the results from the analysis revealed that a non-toxic substance was detected in Peter's serum, while that of Paul was suspected to be highly reactive and toxic. Okay. So, the question they asked is, what could be the likely reasons for the disparity in the results of the analysis conducted on the two brothers, and what are the probable events that could have happened to the administered drug? Okay. So, here Peter is a vegetarian and in his blood a non-toxic molecule is detected. Paul is an alcoholic, in his blood highly reactive and toxic molecule is detected. Okay. This is the key to understand this. They have given paracetamol. So, the answer to this is what? Alcohol induces cytochrome P450, especially cytochrome P2E1. Okay, this isoform is involved in both metabolism of alcohol and paracetamol. Okay, alcohol on chronic consumption will induce this microsomal enzymes. Okay, so microsomal enzymes are induced by alcohol. Now, there is excess cytochrome P450 is there in this person, Paul's blood. Okay, so what will happen? As there is excess cytochrome P450, there will be excess N-acetyl-p-benzoquinoneimine, and this is your reactive toxic molecule given in the question.